Hey everybody, so I'm back to film the OCC lip tar video that I promised after IMATS. I know it's been so long and everyone's really, really mad at me, but it's here. Calm down. It took a while. I mean, it takes a while to review things, and I always have more things to review, and I always end up reviewing the foundation first. I know. But I have a lot of video requests, and no matter how many videos I record, I seem to have a lot of more video requests afterwards, so this one, I guess, took a backseat to a lot of the request. I don't typically review lip products. I'm not a huge lip product type of person. I'm not a big fan of them, but I think the OCC lip tars are very, I guess, I don't know, interesting to everybody, and I wanted to get this done. So let's just talk about them first and foremost. OCC lip tars, they are from the brand OCC, which is also known as Obsessive Compulsive Cosmetics. I think the name is pretty gangster. I like it. Not a gangster, you know, really cool. But I picked these up at IMATS. They are usually at a lot of trade shows. You can find OCC lip tars on their website, which I think is occmakeup.com, which I'll link down below. And you can also find them at Sephora now, or at least Sephora's website. But I don't think it's at every Sephora store. Store-wise, they're only available in 11 stores, which I will list down in the info box as well. Some in California, like Santa Monica and such like that. One in Miami, one in Vegas, but nothing that isn't like a big city, in my opinion. Most of them are in California, New York. Toronto has one, but nothing in my area or anything like that, so.
Boom.
Lip tars are priced at $16 a piece. These are the new packagings for lip tars. They looked a little different before, but that does not matter now. These are the new ones. They come with this little precise tip in this big squeeze tube, and the amount of products you get can last you a lifetime. Yet the shelf life for these are only about a year, so it kind of sucks. And I have 17 different shades to show you guys. I also have the clear lip tar, which is for mixing. These lip tars are extremely pigmented. Literally, a little bit does go a super long way with these. And that is very important to keep in mind, because if you apply too much, it can end up staining your face. If it, you know, moves, it can take longer to dry. It can end up feathering if you apply too much. Literally, the minimum amount you can put on that covers your lips is the best thing for you to do. Otherwise, it'll get all over your teeth. And they do leave a bit of a stain because they are long wearing. After they dry, they go from like a glossy finish to a semi-matte finish. It's not super, super matte, but it's decently matte. There are a little over 30 shades of lip tar. They always release out a couple of new ones as well, so even more than 30. And imagine mixing them. It's so many lip colors to go through. It's ridiculous. The directions to apply these basically says use the tiniest amount or tiniest bead and use it with a lip brush for a complete opaque coverage on your lips. You can mix the shades, wear it on its own. Applying too much product can result in feathering outside of the lining, what I just said. But it feels very cooling on the lips. I like that. It has like a menthol effect in a way. Like very minty. Spearminty. I like that feeling though. It doesn't plump your lips in any way, but it feels good. It's nice and cooling. And each tube comes with 0.33 fluid ounces or 10 milliliters. And then on the front, it just basically says OCC lip tar, and it says it's 100% vegan and cruelty free. So for all my people who want cruelty free lip colors, these are for you. Before I remove this lip color and show you guys swatches of everything, I am going to tell you what's on my lips. It is the CoverGirl Delish lipstick. I love this lipstick. It's my favorite drugstore, like peachy nude. Very nice and moisturizing. And then I used my new NYX Glam Gloss in Disco Playground on top of it, which is like this vibrant gold. Love it. So I'm done enjoying my sweater lip color, and now I'm going to wipe it off. Luckily, it doesn't really stain, so we're good to go. I'm going to try to show you guys the more neutral colors before showing you the bolder colors, because the staining issue is going to come about. But just bear with me, it's gonna happen. I can't avoid it. I'm not gonna use any lip liners. I'm just gonna use straight up lip tar by itself and then a lip brush. I do also have the OCC lip brush. So I'm gonna start off with like the nudie brown colors. Nudie. But I have six of them, and then I'm gonna go into the pinks and then the bolder pinks and then the reds. owner of the brand, David, ran into me at IMAX, and then he offered all of these to me, which was super, super sweet. So these might not have been all the colors I would have picked out, but these are the ones that he recommended me to try. This is way too much, I'm pretty sure. But you do need more of the nude colors than the bolder colors, but this is probably too much already. Okay, forgive me if my application isn't perfect, because I'm gonna end up washing it off anyways. I don't really feel like perfecting it every single time, or I'm gonna end up wiping it off. So this color is Inner Lace.
I'm just gonna show you guys the lip colors one by one. This one's so beautiful. And as I go through them, you're gonna notice there's more staining on my lips, and the foundation and face makeup around my mouth starts to wear off because of all the wiping with the makeup wipe. You can see right now it's starting to come off, and eventually I was like, screw it, I'm just wiping off all the foundation around my mouth. So it's gonna start to be a little distracting, and you can see I'm trying to cover it up with my hands because it can help it from happening, especially with the more pigmented colors. During removal, it's got all over my face. You can see, ooh, all over. And the staining. But yeah, I tried to get through them all. I hope you guys enjoyed. Regardless.